Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this glorious opportunity. And we thank you for the glorious things you are going to do. We thank you for your power. We thank you for the authority. We thank you for the anointing. We thank you because you are going to open the heavens. We pray that you'll do the impossible. You will cure the incurable. You will save every soul. You will draw believers to yourself. And those who are hearing over the transmission, as the anointing is flowing over here, breaking every yoke over here, everywhere they hear the sound of the word of God, miracles will be happening there too. Tonight will be a special night, a glorious night for everyone in Jesus' name. Perform your word in everyone. We thank you because we know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you. It's the day of your joy. According to the word of God, you can see that God bless you. According to Mark chapter 1, and I'm reading verses 40, 41, and 42. Mark chapter 1 verse 40. And there came a leper to him. And there came a leper to him. Study your Bible. Look at history. Look at everything that happened before this time. It is very rare that anybody having leprosy will come to a prophet. Yes, it happened between Naaman and Elisha. Hundreds of years before this time. But apart from that, look at the whole of history for a leper who knew that he was incurable. A leper who knew that once the problem came, it was permanent. To come to a man of God, to come to a prophet, to come to a servant of God, it was like an impossible case. But this man came, and you have come.
It was it, you are.
I said you have come.
What
you have come for something. Are you there? I said you have come for something. That thing you have come for, no matter how difficult tonight, you are going to receive. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him and leaning down to him, and saying unto him, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. If thou wilt, thou canst make me clean.
He
says, all I want you know, if you want to, if you desire
to,
if you have the love for me, you want to touch me, I know there is nothing impossible for you. When you come with that attitude, when you come with that disposition, when you come with that mind, and you say, I know God loves me, he does not want me to continue to suffer, and if he wills, if he wants, if he desires, he can make me clean. He can make me whole. He can change my life. He can turn my life around. He can cleanse me. He can heal me. He can give me a miracle. If thou wilt. If thou wilt. If thou wilt. I know Satan cannot hinder you. If thou wilt. Incurable disease cannot hinder you. In that will, there is nothing in me that will stop you. He said, it was affirming, it was confirming the almighty power of Jesus Christ. And he was saying, nothing can hinder Jesus. Tonight, there's an express way between you and Jesus Christ. Miracle coming your way. I said, miracle coming your way. background will not hinder Jesus. Satan will not hinder Jesus. Evil spirit will not hinder Jesus. Because a yoke in your life will not hinder Jesus. Whatever you have done in the past, whatever happened in the past, will not hinder.
If thou wilt,
thou canst make me clean. And Jesus moved with compassion. Jesus was moved with compassion. He was moved with love. He was moved with mercy. That mercy is coming your way today. That compassion is coming your way today. The love of God is coming your way today. He loves everyone. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish. I'm looking for somebody there, will not perish. I'm looking for somebody there, will not perish. Because Jesus has love. Because Jesus has compassion. And Jesus moved with compassion. Put forth his hand. And he touched him. And he touched him. And he touched him. Hold on. If you go back to the old covenant, if you go back to the time of Moses, the high priest must not touch a leper. The priest must not touch the leper. Ordinary person should not touch a leper. If you touch a leper, you become unclean. And if you don't want to become unclean and be rendered useless, you cannot have any service anymore. You will not touch the leper. But Jesus does not catch what you have, you catch what he has. He touches everyone. He touches the people that have contagious disease. And he doesn't catch their contagion. But they catch his health. They catch his power. They catch his authority. It's going to touch you tonight. As we pray, as we mention the name of Jesus, a touch will come to that head. And that head that is boiling like boiling water. A touch is coming upon that head. That person that is mad and insane, the touch of Jesus is coming upon you. That tumor there that is your belly, the touch of Jesus is coming. That thing will vanish away. That cancer will dry up. That blindness will go away. A touch from Jesus. I said a touch from Jesus. It's touching your life tonight. And when he touches you, all those evil things will vanish away. The miracle is coming your way. I said the miracle is coming your way. And he touched him and says, I will be thou clean. And as soon as he had spoken in verse 42, immediately the leprosy departed from him. And he was cleansed. Testimony time. I said testimony time. The Lord will touch you. Somebody there has a testimony. I said somebody there has a testimony. Where are you? It's coming your way. It will happen. I'm talking to you tonight on the miracle of Christ's supernatural touch. The miracle of Christ's supernatural touch.
There
is always a miracle in the touch of Jesus.
He
touches you and you are cleansed.
He
touches you, your blindness is gone.
He
touches you and your incurable disease is gone.
He
touches you and your soul is saved.
He
touches you and he raises the dead. He touches you and the issue of blood will dry up. He touches the food and he raises plenty out of scanty. And then he turns misery into miracle. He'll turn your misery tonight. Your suffering tonight. Your sickness tonight. Quickly, three things. Number one, the corruption and the confinement of lepers without Christ. The corruption and the confinement of lepers without Christ. Number two, the coming and confidence of a leper in Christ. The coming and the confidence of a leper in Christ. Number three, the cleansing and the cure of lepers by Christ. The cleansing and the cure of lepers by Christ. Number one, the corruption and the confinement. The corruption and the confinement. Well, in the Old Testament, if you read your Bible, you'll find in Leviticus chapter 13, it talks about the leper. When somebody became a leper, and they look at the things spreading in his body, there was no cure. It was incurable. And because it was a contagious disease, they will confine that person outside the camp. It was a deadly disease regarded as incurable. It was a deadly disease, a corrupting effect of a disease. It corrupted the blood. It corrupted the veins. It even affected their bones. Eventually, the fingers will begin to chop off. Eventually, the toes will begin to get off. And because of that kind of corruption, affecting the blood and the bone and the skin, it was a terrible sin and it became worse and worse every time. Degenerating into rottenness.
And
so they'll put the person outside the camp. Do you know that there's a reason there why they put the person outside the camp? Because of the contagion, it will spread. It will go from A to B, from B to C, from D to E, and will be spreading all over the camp.
The rottenness,
the filthiness, the corruption, the defilement, that's the situation of the sinner. Actually, as you look at the Bible, you look at the leper, you look at the sinner. The sinner is like the leper. There's a leprosy of the soul. There's a leprosy of the life. There's a leprosy of the character. And it is contagious. It brings corruption to the character. It brings defilement to the character. It brings evil to the character. And it's an incurable sin. And the leper could not cleanse himself. So the sinner could not save himself. Because sin is a moral decay. Sin is moral corruption. And sin, there's depravity. There is rottenness. There is defilement. And then there's corruption. And then there's contagion. And moral defilement. And moral corruption. Look at the way Jesus said it.
I'm
reading here from Mark chapter 7. Mark chapter 7. I'm reading from verse 20. And he said, that which cometh out of the man defileth the man.
Nibeli just so we pay, oh, also we pay a utility when your daddy, a utility,
for from within,
little Latino one,
out of the heart of man,
Latino,
proceed evil thoughts, adultery,
Bansaga,
fornication,
Agbere,
murders,
Ipanion,
sex,
only
covetousness, wickedness. And then he says, deceit and lasciviousness, an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. Look at the conclusion of Jesus Christ. Look at the statement of Jesus Christ. And see what the Lord is saying. In verse 23, he says, all these evil things, all these evil things, they come from within. And they defile the man. Defilement. The defilement that comes upon the sinner. And as I told you, that contagious thing, that evil thing, that is called sin, it is contagious. It is corrupting. And it brings confinement. That's why, except you are cleansed. That's why. Except your purge. That's why, except the blood of Jesus will wash you. Except that happens, what will happen? There will be a confinement forever and forever.
You'll
be confined to hellfire. Because that's what God does for the leper. The sinner, like the leper, will be confined. Will be banished, will be isolated, will be cast out, will be abandoned outside the camp if he's not cleansed and saved and set free. That's why that leper, that leper was saying, will I remain in this confinement forever? I cannot go out. I cannot mix with people. I cannot interact with people because of that corruption, because of that defilement, and because of all the uncleanness. And he said, but what can take my leprosy away? Just like you are saying, as a sinner, defiled, contaminated, and then you are corrupt, and there's that evil sin, and the depravity of that sin is coming from the very source of your life. And you are saying, what can take my sins away? What can wash my sins away? What can touch my life tonight? What can cleanse my life tonight? What can save my soul tonight? Thank God Jesus is your Savior. I said, thank God Jesus is your Savior. Where are you? I said, where are you? The cleansing of the blood of Jesus will come to you. Forgiveness from the blood of Jesus will come to you. In total change, a total cleansing, a total realization of the cleansing power of the blood of Jesus will come to you tonight. That's why he came. He said, who will I go to? If I go to synagogue, no, they don't heal the lepers in synagogues. If I go to religion doesn't do this. Where will I go? And then he heard of Jesus, the Savior. Jesus the Redeemer. Jesus the Healer. Jesus the Deliverer. Jesus the Miracle Worker. Point number two, the coming and the confidence of a leper to Christ. Have you seen how it said in that passage? Look at that place again, Mark chapter 1 verse 40. And there came, and there came, and there came a leper unto Jesus. He didn't tell anything to hold him back. He didn't tell anything to hold him down. He didn't allow anything to stop his movement. He said, I will go to Jesus. When you make up your mind, take an irreversible decision, I will go to Jesus. That decision will change your life. That decision will change your destiny. That decision will cleanse your soul. That decision will save your soul. And there came a leper to Jesus. And he
kneeled
down to him.
But
why was he doing that? He said, I regard you as my God. I regard you as my Lord. I regard you as my master. I regard you as a supernatural. Son of David, son of God. Son of man, son of God. You're going to change my life. He kneeled down to him. He submitted his life to him. He surrendered his life to him. I'm looking at somebody there today. Praise the Lord for that man. Praise the Lord for that woman.
Unto
Jesus I surrender.
Unto
him I freely give. And you come and you kneel before him. I will not lead to idol anymore. I lean to Jesus. I will not lead to idol worship anymore. I lean to Jesus. No other master. No other leader. No other captain. No other savior.
Kosi olugbala miran.
Jesus. He will be my savior. Jesus and Jesus alone.
Jesus and Jesus
only. Jesus and Jesus only.
Jesus and Jesus only.
And he kneeled to him.
O si kunle.
And then as he came, whatever he was using before, whatever juju he had before, whatever he was rubbing before, all that he threw away. He said, only Jesus.
Only Jesus nikan.
We cannot have Jesus and idol.
Ah, the Jesus ati orisa papo.
Jesus and candle.
Jesus ati abela.
Jesus and incense.
Jesus ati turari.
Jesus and water in the bottle.
Jesus ati omi ninu iko.
Jesus and oil.
Jesus ati ororo.
Jesus and whatever.
Jesus ati
Jesus and Jesus alone.
Jesus and Jesus nikan.
Not Jesus and Mary.
Kise Jesus ati Maria.
Not Jesus and Peter.
Kise Jesus ati Peteru.
Not Jesus and Stephen.
Kise Jesus ati
Stefano. He came to Jesus.
O to Jesus wa.
Only Jesus.
O Jesus nikan.
Is your savior tonight.
O ni olugbalare lale
yi. I said it's your healer tonight.
O ni oluwosanre lale
yi. I said it's your deliverer tonight.
O ni oni oludandere lale
yi. And he looked at him.
Osi wo.
And he looked at him.
Oh, wo.
And he said, Jesus,
only Jesus,
be my Lord.
Jeoluwa mi.
Jesus,
Jesus,
be my Savior.
Jeolugbala mi.
Jesus,
Jesus,
be my controller.
Jeolakoso mi.
And if you will,
bi wo ba si fe,
whatever you will is what I want now.
Oh, to ba fe ni mo fe ba yi.
If thou wilt, thou can make me clean.
Bi wo ba fe, wo le so mi di mimo.
And when he came with confidence.
Nigba to si wo wa pelu igboya.
He knew, I'm coming to Jesus.
O mo bi pe mo to Jesus bo.
I will not go back the same.
I'm
coming to Jesus. When I get back home today,
and people see me,
they will see I am clean. They will see I am cured. They will see I am healed. It's happening to somebody there today. The touch of Jesus. Connection with Jesus. The power of Jesus. That's how the sinner comes. That's how the sinner comes. The one that has the leprosy of sin. The contagion of sin. The one that has all the defilement of sin. That's why he he comes, I cannot save myself. I cannot make myself better. I tried, but I failed. The six, I didn't want to do, that's what I did. And the six are to do, that's what I cannot do. If I
then
do that which I don't want to do, I confess it is not me, but sin that dwelleth in me. Oh, wretched man that I am. Oh, sinful man that I am. Incapacitated, incompetent man that I am. Who shall deliver me and save me from this body of death? And he says, I thank my God. Because of Jesus Christ. Confidence in Jesus. What you cannot do for yourself, Jesus will do for you. What papa and mama cannot do for you, Jesus will do for you. And what religion cannot do for you, tonight Jesus will do for you. The coming and the confidence of the leper to Christ. He came as you are coming tonight. And when you come tonight, you come with faith, you come with trust, you come with confidence, you will save your soul. Whosoever shall come on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But you know, that leper came. He confessed, I am a leper. I need cleansing. As a sinner comes, he must confess, I am a sinner. I need salvation. I need forgiveness. I need a change. I need transformation. You see, as you come, and then you know your condition. Sinful, weak, sick, falling, guilty, condemned, a confined outcast person. You are telling the Lord, this is what you can do. Only Jesus can save. Only Jesus can save. That religion cannot save. Only Jesus can save. Water from River Jordan cannot save. Only Jesus can save. Talisman or whatever you bind on yourself cannot save.
And
then you come, you say, I cannot save myself.
He
said, my leprosy is deeper than my skin. Yes, it's on my skin. But it's deeper than my skin. The leprosy has gone through every blood system. The same thing with the sinner. Your sin is more than what we see on the outside. It's more than the stealing outside. It's more than bending down to idol outside. It's an issue of the mind. It's an issue of the heart. You see, did my mother conceive me? In iniquity was I born? He says, can the leopard change his skin? The leopard, can it change his skin? No, he cannot change his skin. And so are you. Because it's something of the heart. For the heart is depraved and deceptive. But when you bring it to the Lord,
he
says, I will cleanse you. Tonight cleansing is coming to you. Tonight salvation is coming to you. You cannot do it yourself. That's what the leper realized. He said, there is no means on earth. There is no medicine on earth that can change my condition of leprosy. Only Jesus. And you know there is no condition on earth. There is no remedy on earth. And there is no means on earth that can turn your life around and take your sin away and give you the victory and set you free. But thank the Lord. If the Son therefore shall make you free,
you
shall be free indeed. Somebody there is getting free tonight. I said somebody there is getting free tonight. He will set you free. He will set you free. He will change everything in your life. And then you'll be able to say, touch touched me.
O fowo kan mi.
He healed me.
O wo mi san.
He saved me.
O gba mi la.
He forgave me.
O dariji mi.
He changed my life.
O ye aye mi pada.
He transformed me.
O so mi di otun.
Tonight is that night.
Ale yi ni ale na
o. I said tonight is that night.
Mo ni asale yi ni asale na.
The touch of the Lord is coming on somebody there.
Ifowo kan Oluwa to enikan bo lale yi.
Where is the person there?
Eni na da.
I said where is the person there?
Mo ni eni yen da.
Miracle of salvation.
Ise iyanu ti.
Miracle of deliverance.
Ise iyanu ti dan.
Miracle of healing.
Ise iyanu ti iwosan.
The miracle of redemption.
Ise iyanu ti irapada.
See what the Lord did. Point number three now.
Koko keta bayi.
The cleansing and the cure of lepers by Christ.
Iwenumo ati iwosan adete nipasẹ Christ.
The cleansing and the cure of lepers by Christ.
Iwenumo ati iwosan adete nipasẹ Christ.
It tells us in verse 42.
O so fun ni ese ikeji le logoji.
And as soon as he had spoken.
Bi o si ti soro.
Immediately.
Loju kan na.
Miracle is coming tonight.
Ise iyanu bo lale yi.
Immediately.
Loju kan na.
The power of God is coming tonight.
Agbara Olorun bo lale yi.
Immediately.
Loju kan na.
Your redemption is coming tonight.
Irapada re bo lale yi.
Somebody is getting saved there today.
Enikan gba iwosan lale yi.
Forgiveness is coming somewhere there today.
Enikan gba idariji lale yi.
Redemption is coming somewhere there today.
Irapada n to enikan bo lale yi.
He will cleanse your sin.
Yo dare se re
ti o. He will save your soul.
Yo gbo okan re la.
He will break the chain of sin in your life.
Yo ja ewun ese kuro ninu aye re.
There is something that only Jesus can do. Salvation. There's something only Jesus can do. Forgiveness. There's something that only Jesus can do.
He'll
take away from the confinement of the leper.
He
will cleanse you.
He
will cure you.
He
will heal you.
Become,
it's like you never got any leprosy in your life before.
Like
you never had any sickness in your life before. No deformity in your life before. Look at that man. It's like he was never blind before. Miracle time. I said miracle time. It's for you. I said it's for you. In verse 42, as soon as he has spoken, immediately the leprosy departed from him. Immediately the leprosy departed from him. That's why I say, before we pray, check up what the problem is.
If
you're blind, check up. If you're lame, check up. If you're hunchback, check up. If you're arthritis, check up. If you're cancer, check up.
If
you're anybody that is mad, check up. And then I say, you raise up your hand and you lay your hand the other place. And I say, when you hear the final amen, immediately something will register there. I said, immediately something will register there. Your miracle will come. Your miracle will come. Praise the Lord, I see you there. I see the flow of the power of God in your life tonight in Jesus' name. It will wipe your tears away. It will take your sorrow away. Confinement has come to an end in your life. As soon as he had spoken, immediately the leprosy departed from him and he was cleansed. And he was cleansed. Well, he's got his own. You are going to get your own. Let me read it now for you. Verse 42. As soon as Jesus has spoken, immediately the sickness departs from you and you are cured. I can't hear my people. Immediately your sin departs from you and you are saved. And you are saved. What a glorious night, what a joyful night. A night of salvation. A night of cleansing. Because Jesus Christ has power. The power to cleanse. The power to kill. The power to heal. And whatever disease is tonight, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Tonight is your night. It is your turn to give. give your testimony. He has the power to deliver. Every power of evil is spoken away from your life tonight. He has the power to forgive and to save. The guilt will go away. Condemnation will go away. The punishment for sin will go away. He has the power to liberate and set you free. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. He has the power to remove the curse out of your life. That curse that has been following you until this time. Tonight is that night. The curse is taken away. And it is going to happen immediately. Jesus has all power to transform sinners to saints. And to transform a leper to a clean person. And then come back here now. Mark chapter 1. Mark chapter 1. And there came a leper unto him. He doesn't come until you come. That is, the miracle doesn't come until you come. The power does not flow until you come. It is your coming. It is your coming that draws the power of God into your life. And he came. And you come. And you come. And you come. I said that you come. And then the power from heaven will flow into your life. Beseeching him and kneeling down unto him. He came and surrendered. I surrender my life. I surrender my soul. I give myself unreservedly unto Christ. He came and he knelt down. You are my Lord. You are my Savior. You are my Redeemer. You are my Deliverer. You are my Healer. As you come, and he came confidently. Because he told him, he said, Jesus, if thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. I knew you have the power to save. You can save me. You have the power to heal. You will heal me. You have the power to deliver. You deliver me. And Jesus was moved with compassion. Compassion is coming your way. Mercy is coming your way. He does not reject anyone. I was born on the other side of the fence. It doesn't matter. I was born in the jungle. It doesn't matter. I was born somewhere. It doesn't matter. I was born in wickedness. It doesn't matter. As many as will come. As many as will come. They will receive you. They will cleanse your soul. They will heal your body. They will change your life. Today is a new day in your life. It's a day of your birth. Let's forget the past. A change of destiny. A change of life. A change of prospect. A change of direction. You are starting a new life today. It came unto Christ. And when he came, the Lord touched him.
Oluwa fowokan.
The Lord touched him.
Oluwa fowokan.
A touch.
Ifowokan.
Miracle touch.
Ifowokan ise iyanu.
A touch.
Ifowokan.
Supernatural touch.
Ifowokan toke wa.
A touch.
Ifowokan.
A saving touch.
Ifowokan olugbala.
A touch.
Ifowokan.
A touch of healing.
Ifowokan iwosan.
The Lord is ready.
Oluwa setan.
Anybody getting ready there?
Enikeni asetan ibe
yen. I said anybody getting ready there.
Enikeni asetan ibe yen.
Salvation.
Igbala.
Forgiveness.
Idariji.
A change of life.
Iyipada igbe aye.
Bowed and eyes closed. The Lord is saying, if you will come to me, I forgive your sin. The Lord is saying, if you will come to me, I will cleanse your life. I will change your life. He will write your name in the book of heaven. Book of life in heaven. And then all the confinement, everything will be over.
It's
bowed and eyes closed. If you want to come like this leper king, you're coming for salvation. You're coming for forgiveness. You're coming for a change. change of life.
You
say, Jesus, you're the only one that can save me. And I come. And you come with confidence in Christ. If you're coming to Christ,
you
raise up your hand. It's going to change your life now. It's going to forgive your sin now. It's going to cleanse you now. It's going to bring eternal life unto you now. If you're raising up your hand, you will stand up. I submit my heart to Jesus. Thank you. I submit my life to Jesus. Thank you. I give myself to Jesus. You stand up there. Wonderful, wonderful. Wonderful wonders come into your life today. In Jesus' name we pray. You pray after me now in English. So you say what I say. Are you ready? And you say from the depth of your heart. Are you ready? Lord Jesus, I come today. I come to you. I confess. I am a sinner. I'm just like the leper. I cannot cleanse myself. I cannot save myself. But I know you, Jesus, will save me. Jesus will save me. I come. I trust. I believe. I am confident you will forgive me today. Lord Jesus, I believe you died for me to take my sins away. Your blood will wash me. Your blood will cleanse me. I accept that forgiveness now. I accept the forgiveness now. I accept that cleansing now. I can't hear you again. I accept that cleansing now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I am forgiven. Thank you. I am cleansed. Thank you. I am saved. In Jesus' name I pray. And everybody said, raise up those hands of surrender to the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for all those who have come to Jesus and they came with confidence that Jesus will cleanse them, that he will save them, that he will change their lives. Lord, I pray, give them the touch of salvation, the touch of cleansing, the touch of forgiveness, and let your spirit bear witness in their hearts, that you have answered their prayer. You have saved them. You have cleansed them. Let that change be visible in their lives. Write the names in the book of life in heaven. Thank you, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Anybody wanting a miracle there? Remember now, it's for everybody. Our invitees, God bless you. I praise the Lord for you. A miracle is coming your way. Our members and workers, praise the Lord for you. Today is your day. A miracle has come for you. Our leaders, men and women, praise the Lord. You must have your share tonight. You raise up one hand. You lay the other hand where the problem is. And then when you hear the final amen, I see the miracle already. Raise up that hand. Father, in Jesus' name, we bless your name. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. God who cannot fail. You are the God who has not changed. And your people are waiting for you. And your people are coming with confidence, knowing that all power belongs to you. And I bring everyone before you tonight. Lord, miracle for everyone. Healing for everyone. Deliverance for everyone. Confirm it in every life in Jesus' name. command that spirit of insanity come out in Jesus' name. That madness, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. That spirit of epilepsy, you have no right to remain there. The power of Christ comes against you. Epilepsy, come out in Jesus' name. That leprosy and skin disease, be cleansed and be cured right now in Jesus' name. From the top of your to the tip of your toe, receive that cleansing. Receive that healing. Be cured in Jesus' name. Any incurable disease there, I pray, Lord, the Lord will touch you right now. Lord, touch them. Lord, touch them. Incurable disease, be cured in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have any swelling in their body. Swelling on the chest area. Swelling at the back. Swelling in your legs. Swelling any other part. I command that swelling come out in Jesus' name. I pray for those who have cancer. Lord, healing has come. I command that cancer be healed in Jesus' name. I pray for the people that have anemia. Come out in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. That issue of blood coming from any part of the body, I command that issue of blood dry up right now. Miracle. Be healed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who have dim eyesight. For those who are blind, whether they have glaucoma or cataract, I command that deafness and blindness come out in Jesus' name. Blind eyes be open and begin to see. Every deformity in that eye, Lord, touch them and make them see in Jesus' name. And for those who are deaf and dumb, let darkness vanish away. Let darkness vanish away. I begin to hear. I begin to speak. Lord, perform that miracle right now in them. I pray for those who have arthritis. All the pain of arthritis, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. One leg shorter than the other. That short leg, I command you, grow out in Jesus' name. That withered hand, come alive in Jesus' name. Those who are paralyzed in any way, the power of Christ to come upon you. Rise up and walk. Power to come upon you. Power your waist. Power in your knees. Power in your ankle. Power in your nerves. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for everyone. Every yoke is broken. All the curses are removed. The impossibilities are possible. Barrenness is gone. The sorrow is taken away. An outstanding problem is totally removed. Mountain move. Lord, everywhere. Everywhere, in the front, everywhere, 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 everywhere